U.S. Army could soon get an interesting weapon. Mach Industries has received a substantial contract from the U.S. Army Applications Laboratory to create the Strategic Strike, a vertical takeoff VTO cruise missile intended to improve the precision strike capabilities of maneuver units. In a press release dated March 4th, the company stated that this contract, awarded in the third quarter of 2024, establishes Mach Industries as a leader in defense technology, with a particular emphasis on enhancing operational effectiveness at the brigade level. The company stated, "The combination of VTO, high speed, and range payload is radically novel for the current fighting force. At the culmination of the contract, Mach will provide the warfighter with a VTO asset that has HIMARS range, cruise missile speed, and Hellfire effects." In this video, Defense Updates reports on Mach Industries' innovative strategic strike missile. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The evolving battlefield has introduced new challenges for maneuver units, notably the rise of low-cost, portable intelligence, surveillance and reconnaissance, ISR assets. Targeting high-value enemy assets often necessitates coordination across multiple military branches and organizational levels. Modifying high-value targets often necessitates coordination across multiple military branches and organizational levels. Mach Industries is trying to fill this gap with Strategic Strike Missile. The Strategic Strike Missile boasts an impressive operational range of 180 miles, 290 kilometers, capable of carrying a warhead exceeding 22 pounds, 10 kilograms. The range is reportedly policy constrained and could be enhanced. As per reports, powered by a turbojet engine, the missile can cruise at 550 miles per hour, 885 kilometers per hour. So the speed is similar to Tomahawk cruise missile. This unique combination of vertical takeoff capability, high speed, and substantial payload capacity distinguishes it in the current landscape of military assets. The Strategic Strike Missile is designed to substantially improve a maneuver force's ability to precisely target and destroy high-value assets located deep beyond enemy front lines, like radar sites and artillery positions. A key objective of this missile system is to facilitate launches from positions beyond the enemy's engagement range. This way, the platform is expected to provide flexibility to forces under diverse combat situations and increase the survivability of launch crews operating in contested environments. Mach Industries, headquartered in Huntington Beach, California, is backed by leading venture firms such as Sequoia Capital and Bedrock Capital. Ethan Thornton, CEO and founder of Mach Industries, who is a MIT dropout, expressed his appreciation for the contract and his team's progress. Thornton noted, "It's a tremendous opportunity to deliver a capability that could transform military operations. I'm continually impressed by our engineering and manufacturing teams, who have taken Strategic Strike from initial design to flight testing in just 14 weeks. The dedication and talent of our product team will provide valuable advancements for the U.S. military at a critical juncture." After securing the contract, Mach Industries swiftly progressed the Strategic Strike program, completing the missile's design by late September 2024. By mid-January 2025, the company had successfully concluded essential testing stages, showcasing the missile's seamless shift from vertical takeoff to sustained wingborne flight. Presently, the team is focused on incorporating cutting-edge artificial intelligence-driven visual and radio frequency sensing technologies, enabling the missile to operate effectively in contested environments where GPS and communication systems are disrupted or unavailable. Thornton, who is now 21, stated, "I truly think the product team we've assembled here will drive generational value to the U.S. at this critical time." Thornton noted, "The concept anticipates that the Strategic Strike Missile will be cheap enough, when ordered in volume to compare with the unit price of short-range guided rockets, such as the Army's guided multiple launch rocket system. Thornton said, "It's low cost enough to use like you would rocket-based artillery at very, very, very high volumes. The weapon is currently at an experimental stage, and the U.S. Army Applications Laboratory reportedly ordered 5 units from the company for proof of concept. Mach Industries has plans to build a 115,000 square feet factory in Huntington Beach, where its headquarters is located." The strategic strike missile's development seems set to significantly influence how the military tackles evolving threats, highlighting the critical role of innovation in advancing defense technologies. This weapon could address 2 key areas: increased agility in battlefield and low-cost precision fire. Drones and satellites have the modern battlefield transparent. The war in Ukraine has shown that amassing large troop formations and weapons in a single area is fraught with danger. The more apt solution is to have distributed units which are self-sufficient to a large extent. But these units don't have the capabilities to engage long-range targets on their own and have to go up the command chain, which induce delays. Arming the tactical maneuver units with strategic strike missile will change this and improve response times. It is important to note that to deploy this weapon effectively, the U.S. Army would need to extend command and control systems for long-range fires to the small unit level, rather than reserve such technologies for brigade or division-level formations. The second aspect is that a modern-day conflict places tremendous load on economy and supply chain. Even Russia, which has a big military-industrial complex, faced issues with the supply of PGMs, or precision-guided munitions, and had to reach out to Iran for the supply of Shahed drones. It is very difficult, both economically and in terms of manufacturing capacity, to keep producing expensive and complex weapons in large quantities. For reference, Russian Kaliber missile costs about $5 million. An American Tomahawk is pegged at around $2.5 million. HIMARS launched Army Tactical Missile System has price tag of $1.5 million, and GMLRS costs $0.5 million. A simple, low-cost weapon that can be mass-produced is a more sustainable solution in a modern conflict. It will be interesting to see how strategic strike missile evolve.